Oh, yes. And where should we find him? Over that way. Learn more about Menogius and Bananas from Jean Yun. It's actually crazy. Alright, jamming. Okay.
Ah, perfect. You're all here. There's an important commission I need your help with.
An important commission, you say?
Right. I've got the time. Where are the goods?
Well, it's not just goods this time. I need you to escort a tea merchant and their wares from Chowdhury Village to Biyue Harbor. A very important client has requested to meet with him.
Oh.
Sure. What's this merchant's address?
Here.
Oh.
The client's that important, then this must be a very crucial, very pressing commission, right?
Of course, the sooner you complete it, the better. I would advise you to depart as soon as possible.
Oh, that's fine by me.
Alright, don't work too hard now, Longjo. We'll set off then.
Alright, part 3 started. So, I suppose we're going to Chowin Village. At least I would believe so. We're here.
Boats are made for transferring commodities back and forth. And those that come across.
You're a bit quiet today, Gamin. Oh, do you want Paimon to tell a story?
We're almost there. I'll take a rain check.
Deep touch.
Dad?
Oh, so you're Gaming's father. It's nice to meet you. Just leave this delivery to him. Trust Paimon, he's got this in the bag. Gaming is super good at what he does. Everyone at the Secure Transport Agency says as much. Even the Ministry of Civil Affairs has nothing but good things to say about him.
Seems like you've made some sort of name for yourself, at least.
The goods are all in order?
Yes, they're all here.
Then let's get going.
I suppose I will have to trouble you all to escort me, then. Let's go.
Work as armed escorts, Jeff over drumming. Well. Well, I have some silk flower to get here, it seems. Nahida, it seems that it's your time to shine. Right, leave it to me. Sure.
Hey.
have their fireworks set up for here.
I see everything.
Sure.
What about you? You're not going to join us?
Wait, is that Cloud Retainer in the background?
I'm not tired. I'll keep watch.
Oh, but...
Yeah, but...
Just let him go.
Come on, Yip Tach. This is your son we're talking about. Yeah, who goes there?
It appears that one's movements were overly conspicuous.
You think?
Enough of your music. Focus. Focus on the matter at hand. Present your exquisite ornaments at once.
Indeed. Bring them forth readily and without protest.
What do we do?
It seems as if these two are acting alone. It won't be difficult to subdue them, but... he might have something else waiting in store for Dad. The best way to keep him safe is... leave this to me. I'll handle them. Traveler, Paimon, take my dad and the goods away from here.
No, Kami. It's too dangerous.
This is what I do.
Yeah. Yeah, Paimon.
Let us depart and seek a target softer in blows and disposition.
Don't think I'm gonna let you off so easily.
Yeah, this was it. Yeah, okay. Cloud Retainer was clearly in the background.
Away. Let us away.
Coming!
Don't worry, he's a great fighter. I must even see him take down a dozen of the treasure orders all by himself.
Yeah.
But
speak your mind, my dude. Speak. Yeah. Look at them go.
We should be good to stop here.
Is that Sean Lee? Really? is that Sean Lee? Okay. It should be good to stop here.
Oh no, what is he doing here?
He's flying a kite. Ah, oh, this is in regards to Hu Tao, her ghost companion. Oh, this is so good. Oh, this is so good, Zhongli, my boy. Sir? Do you know who you're talking to? Do you know who is Sean Lee? Oh my god! Oh, he's doing it?
Bandits, acting in broad daylight.
It seems like it. OJ, why don't you turn this top?
Oh.
Oh. Just buy him one.
Ah, I see. It appears many people are catching a chill as of late. If your throat is bothering you, Paimon, perhaps some tea and rest are in order.
He must have figured it all out by now. Is he just plain dumb on purpose?
If there are indeed bandits in the area, then we should inform the Millilith at once.
The guard that was extorting us is already on their tail.
Oh? Well, if that's the case, such matters are best left to those with the necessary expertise, wouldn't you agree?
I suppose you're right. If ordinary people like us got involved, it would only cause more trouble.
Ordinary people, he says. Ordinary people.
Since we find ourselves otherwise unoccupied in this beautiful area, why don't we find a quiet place to relax while we wait for good news?
That would be lovely.
Ah, Shunli, you're the best. Definitely the best. I don't know if we can see I wonder if you can see Xianyun or Cloud Attainer. So we're here, right? This, I think. Anyways, let's go. Alright.
Usho. Performing around Liyue Harbor recently, is it not?
Yep, definitely the one.
Oh, have you seen him perform?
Indeed. I cannot help but admire his skill. He truly encapsulates the spirit of the Tsuami. Usho dancing has become more well known in Liyue Harbor recently. However, although performers are seeing budding success, they have no doubt had to face many hurdles along the way. One's not so easily understood by spectators such as ourselves. If you ask me, what truly deserves admiration is perseverance in the face of adversity. That is a rare attribute indeed.
Oh yes.
I have heard many of my acquaintances praise Gami for his kind, selfless, and courageous disposition. To have a child so accomplished and upright, you must be a very proud parent indeed.
Uncle Yip? I'm sorry? Sorry?
Sounds like Zhongli has decided to skip the formalities.
Yeah.
Well, he's a hard worker. Yes.
You should be sure to tell him you think that when he comes back.
What?
Your son is young yet. It's normal for someone his age to be a bit hot-headed. It's understandable to find talking about such things in person difficult. If there's a particular sentiment you wish to convey, perhaps we could pass it along for you.
No. It wouldn't be right to ask that of you. This thing between us has festered for many years now. In truth, there are some things that simply aren't easy for us to talk through. I've been in the tea business for most of my life, and I always hope my child will do the same. Otherwise, how would he support himself? Over the past few years, I heard how well he was doing for himself as a guard. His work was taking him to farther and farther off places. I also heard that he never gave up on Wuxiu dancing. It made me happy. I was also warning that when you're young, you can handle all that physically taxing work and manual labor. What young person isn't capable of making a living that way? My concern is what happens when you get old. Every time I get to thinking like that, I cannot help but be reinforced in the belief that I was right. That I was right not to give in. I often regret introducing him to Wuxiu dancing as a kid. If I had known how things would turn out, I would have never taken him to see those performances in the first place.
It is only natural for a parent to strive to send their child down the right path. No one would begrudge you that sentiment, Uncle. You need not worry.
You seem quite young, Mr. Zhang Li.
Young, you say?
Yet you speak with such wisdom. Perhaps I have misjudged your age.
Well.
Your words are too kind. Truth be told, one of my old friends has several grown daughters.
Clavitiner.
Rather than fretting about their future, however, she prefers to let them find their own way.
She's more easygoing than I could ever be. I fear I lack such an open mind. I meant to say earlier, there is no need to be so polite. Feel free to call me by my name, Ipta.
Sure.
Okay.
So, do you also think I fret too much, Mr. Zhongli?
That's not exactly what I was hoping to convey. Only a fool would ask a parent not to worry about their child. But think of it this way. Raising a child is not unlike flying a kite. Hold the string too tight, and it can no longer soar. As my friend once said, if your children are aiming for the stars, clipping their wings will only cause them to come crashing down. You need to let out the line for a kite to soar.
It seems I was too stuck in my ways.
You need not reproach your heart for caring. You simply need to loosen your hold a little. Indeed, with such a big heart, why not allocate the time you usually spend worrying about Gami to the pursuit of other things? Like going for a stroll, drinking tea, or taking in the scenery. You never know what surprises could be in store. Things can change in the blink of an eye.
Yeah. So, basically what Zhongli says here is for Yip Tak to actually do what Zhongli's doing. Now that he's retired and no longer Red Slappers. Yeah.
Children grow up in quite the same way, do they not? Day after day, year after year, sometimes in the blink of an eye, but always when you least expect it. As a father, I'm sure you know that best.
Yes, you can say that again. One second, Daming was a kid. The next thing I knew, he was ready to fly the nest.
Daming certainly has a way with words.
Yeah, that's Zhongli for you, a man of wisdom, a man of words.
So,
me in the eye, huh? I guess I'm right then.
But how did you know?
At first, their mannerisms seemed a bit stilted. But once I got close, it was obvious that they possessed great skills.
Mm-hmm.
I was right on their tail, and it should have taken only a few steps to catch up to them, yet somehow, I was never able to close that distance.
Yeah, but they're adept, what do you think?
People with that level of skill would have gone about things differently from the start, like sneaking up on us while we were distracted. Unless, of course, their real motive was to lure me away from the group all along.
Wow, you're pretty quick on the uptake.
Yeah.
I just have a lot of experience. I've dealt with many a ruthless bandit in my time, but I've never seen ones like them. In the end, I told them they would make good guards if they ever wanted to get back on the straight and narrow, and that they could hang out with me and Leo Harbor anyway.
Never consider you might be a little too good at making friends?
I'm guessing you guys were trying to help resolve things between my dad and me?
Yeah. I guess you're right on the money.
Yeah, I appreciate it. I really do. But this conflict between us has been going on for a long time. Even if those two were real bandits, I was able to subdue them and show them what I was capable of. I wouldn't change anything. You've seen the way he talks to me.
It's not like that at all! Dad really cares about you. You should see the way he talks about you when you're not around. Zhang Li was talking things through with him, and he nearly agreed to let it go. You don't believe us?
He won't let it go. He can say as much as he wants to other people, but he won't talk to me. I'm certain of it.
And you? Will you talk to him? Hurt to try.
I'll do my best.
You are very knowledgeable, Mr. Zhang Li. I'm impressed. Despite my being in the tea industry for several decades, it seems, I still have much to learn about the art of tea tasting.
You flatter me. It was nothing but a few humble musings.
It's not like it was alcohol, right, Venti?
Ip Doc and I have found many a common interest. Our friendship, much like a cup of tea, seems to grow stronger the longer it has to steep.
Well said, Mr. Zhong Li.
Hmm.
Gaming, Mr. Zhong Li is very knowledgeable. You should take the opportunity to learn from people like him when you're in the city.
Enjoyed our conversation, but I unfortunately have some unfinished funeral parlor business to attend to.
Oh, I hope I didn't keep you. My apologies for taking up so much of your time, Mr. Zhong Li. No need to stay on my account. When you're less busy, let's find a time to meet. I'll treat you to dim sum.
It would be an honor.
Leave the tea stall and talk to Zhang Li. Right. Let's go do that.
Thanks for helping us talk things through with Uncle Ip. Good thing you were able to pick up on what we were putting down.
I have been around the both of you for some time now. You could say I have a certain level of expertise in that regard. As for my role in the conversation, think nothing of it. I hardly did anything noteworthy.
You never change, do you?
Well, it's Zhang Li for you.
Why did
Zhao. Hey. Hello, Zhao.
Zhao, you're here too.
A friend approaches. A wild Pokemon approaches.
I've been here the whole time.
You've been here the whole time. Ah.
Could that elusive director who be coming to Wangshu in once again? What is she doing here? I suppose it matters not. Given her relationship with Rex, well, Zhongli, I might as well go pay my respects.
Surprise! Yeah.
I would hardly say I roped Zhao into anything. I simply sought the help of a friend. Besides, we did the testing together.
Sounds like our pool of competitors is growing.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. We're going to win either way.
Do you like kite flying, Zhao?
I suppose I neither like nor dislike it. Although, watching the kite gradually ascend into the sky does bring me a certain peace of mind. Perhaps they're a bit like Zhao lanterns in that way.
Kite flying is also a pleasant form of relaxation.
Have you ever thought about making a kite, Zhao? Cloud Retainer taught us how. We can teach you if you want.
There's no need. Minokius was the only Yaksha among us who had an interest in matters of ornamentation and design. When Lantern Rite is over, come find me near Pervasus Temple.
Absolutely. It's been so long.
It's getting late. I should go inform Director Hu of our findings.
Right.
How's she been, by the way? Be sure to say hi to her for us.
The last time I spoke to her, she mentioned that she would be visiting Chaoying Village in a few days.
Really?
If you have the time, perhaps you could also make the trip. If you happen to run into her, you can pass along your regards in person.
That'd be great.
See
ya.
See you next time.
Uh,
to say.
Then I'll go. I still don't want to leave the harbor.
Oh. I can't say I support that decision, but... Hey, let me finish before you get all worked up.
Sit, Shimba, sit. You must be tired from your journey. Shall I pour you a cup of tea, or would you prefer something else to drink?
Okay, so the parallel here, mother and daughter. Oh, wait. Oh, okay, so I see what's going on here. So mother and daughter, and father and son. Two tables, two different, well, points of view, I suppose.
No need, I'm not tired. They're gone, Master. Perfect. The time is nigh for us to make an appearance. Do you remember the plan one recounted to you? Yes, Master. We aim to give them a demonstration of familial love. So I'll have whatever you are having.
All right. What are Auntie Xiaoyan and Shanghai doing here? Just how many people are involved in this? I suppose all I can do is just take a seat and see what happens.
Perfect! I just so happened to have bought some Solo tea recently. It's quite the delectable variety.
Or it would be if one has not been forced to drink it every day in hopes of whittling down one's considerable stash.
Oh yeah.
One has more than had once felt already.
Aw, genuine.
Pit. Such thoughts detract from the present mood to keep up the conversation. Has work been busy during the holiday season? Do you need my help with anything?
Drunk guests can sometimes cause trouble. But I deal with them as you taught me, by pinning their heads against the table.
Pinning their heads against the table? Wow. Yeah. You did forget that one fact, huh?
Do you have any plans for today, Shenhe? How about we do something fun?
That sounds about right. Take her to do something fun, and perhaps she'll loosen up.
Okay, so parental figures.
Like we used to do when we would carry stones up and down the mountain from dawn until dusk, picking herbs to eat for dinner along the way? If that is what you ask of me, then that is what I shall do.
Dad, here, have some tea. Or no, wait, let's not have any just yet.
Yeah.
I simply can't listen to that. Coming. I'd like to finish what I was trying to say before. I don't support your decision to stay in Liyue Harbor, because living there is too hard on me. If you come home, there will be people to help you. I'm not saying we have to live under the same roof. I know our personalities are too similar to avoid butting heads. But you'll have your entire family around you. Your aunts, uncles, they'll all do whatever they can to help. You could get a less taxing job, and we could grab dim sum together from time to time.
Huh. I didn't know dim sum was such an important affair, Master.
Shh. Just think about it. You don't have to decide now.
It has changed a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But I thank you, Dad.
It's been long enough, don't you think? Oh, I'm on sure hopes they've made up by now. Oh, they're drinking tea in silence. That's not a good sign. Did Shenyan's plan not work after all? Hey, you two! I'm sorry we were gone for so long. We got to chatting with some friends and didn't realize how much time had passed.
Perfect timing, actually. We seem to be just about done here.
Yep, let's go. I'll get the Vax.
Gami has grown a lot taller, hasn't he?
Yeah, time drives by. The East girls, though. Shenhe. You girl, some. Okay, well.
Master, did I say something wrong earlier?
I don't know.
I tried to go along with your questions, but when I saw how you and that man reacted, I started to wonder. Not at all. Certain unforeseen variables may have presented themselves along the way, but the outcome proved favorable. The plan was a success. Then I helped? Naturally. Your purity of spirit is one of your greatest strengths, Shenhe. You need not change who you are.
Aww. That's nice. It's amazing. Oh, yes.
A Fontaine market. Then I'll need some time to adequately prepare. Perhaps we could sit down and discuss the questions you intend to ask in advance.
Of course, of course. Please follow me.
Is this person also involved in your plan?
Nope. Yes. She's the very important client.
Here, I thought I had lots of connections. I suppose I've been humbled. You sure know all kinds of cool and important people.
Oh, yes. More than you think.
Over here! Yoo-hoo! Over here!
Huh? What? Auntie Shenyu?
She probably wants to talk about the next phase of the plan. Let's go while your dad is still distracted.
Going well.
Oh, yes.
Don't worry, Shenyan. Everything is going according to plan.
I knew that was all an act earlier. Auntie Shenyan is really something. She was so determined to help me. She didn't even care about making herself and Shenhe appear foolish in front of my family. She truly knows how to look out for others. I still have a lot to learn.
As for the next step.
Oh, no.
What's wrong, Gami?
Don't tell me you're the one splitting the bill for all that tea. I can't let you do that.
Fret not. Reimbursements will be made.
Aww.
Exactly. Think of it more as an investment, as we normally say.
Well, I miss Nick one. True.
Oh, okay. Business-related matters always seem to go over my head, but I refuse to let you all lose more on my behalf. I'll pay you back right now.
We can talk about such matters at a later date. There are more important matters for you to consider at the moment, are there not?
Yes. I've been thinking about it the whole way here. I have an idea, but I'd hate to cause even more trouble for all of you.
That is for us to decide.
Yeah, we're all friends here. Plus, we wouldn't be here if we didn't want to help, right? Just tell us about this idea, please.
Okay. So, it's like this.
So you attach him from behind, and I save him. What?
Let's split up and make it happen. We need to do those things we talked about, but we also still have the kite flying competition. Since Xiao already tested out those kites for us, why don't we also go buy one of those mechanical thingamabobs or whatever they're called? We can attach it to our kite.
Well, okay. Go to the kite stall.